I hope all of you are doing well and stay at your home. Now, I am your Shomashri ma'am from Yad Public School. I want to inform you again, we set the second term syllabus. Take the advantage through this video and we help you to complete your syllabus and to maintain your flow of studies. Now, let's. Student, today we start our next chapter, chapter number 7 in your Treasure of Valor book. Take out the page number 28. The book, the chapter name is Sweet Fruits of Honesty. In this story, you learn about a truthfulness. In this story, you learn about the truthfulness. Now, I read this story, you listen to me and try to listen whatever I say to you. One day, a woodcutter axe accidentally fell into a river, means the first character is the woodcutter. The woodcutter axe accidentally fell into the rivers. After that, the poor woodcutter looked for it in the water for hours but could not find it. He burst into tears. Hearing his sobs, an angel appears before him. When the angel asked him why he was crying, the woodcutter narrated the entire incidents to her. Means, one day the woodcutter axe accidentally fell into the river. After that, woodcutter searched here and there and could not find out his axe. And after that, he started crying. The sound of the crying the angel heard. And after that, the angel appears before the woodcutter and asks the angel to the woodcutter, why are you crying? After that, the woodcutter explained all the incidents. Now, looking at the woodcutter's miserable conditions, the angel looked pity on him. Means after that, the woodcutter condition is not good. He was crying. So that's why after that angels looked very softly towards the woodcutter. He dived into the rivers and came up carrying a golden axe. Here is the picture, if you can see it. Here is the picture, the angel came with a golden axe in the front of a woodcutter. Now, she dived into the rivers and came up carrying a golden axe and offered it to the woodcutter. After that, the angel disappears into the rivers, dived into the rivers, and after that came out with a golden axe and offered the woodcutter to take this golden axe. The axe was made of gold, but the woodcutter was an honest man. He did not accept it and said that this axe was, his axe was made up of wood. When the angel came with a golden axe offered the woodcutter, take this golden axe, that axe was made up of a gold. But when the woodcutter saw axe, after that woodcutter said, this is not my axe. My axe is made with wood and this axe is made of gold. This is not mine. Okay, now go to our next page. The angel, the next character is the angel. An angel take a first is a angel disappears again and soon returned with the silver egg. And after that, hearing this picture, see here, the angel again offered a gold, a silver egg. The woodcutter again refused to accept that egg and said that his egg was made up of wood. Now again the angel disappears, and again soon the angel came and returned and came with the silver eggs. When the woodcutter saw that silver eggs, again the woodcutter refused to accept that silver eggs, and he replied that my eggs is made up of wood. Now the next, the angel offered woodcutter is a silver axe. Next, the angel once again went into the rivers. Now she reappeared carrying the woodcutter's axe. The poor man was very happy and thanked the angel with a great joy. The angel was impressed by the man's honesty. She presented him with the golden eggs and the silver eggs as a reward for his honesty. Means after that the angel again went to the river and reappears carrying the wooden eggs, which that eggs is a woodcutter eggs. And the poor man, when the woodcutter saw that the wooden eggs, the woodcutter was very happy and thanked the angel to return his eggs. When angel saw the happiness, after that the angel decided to represent the three eggs, and the angel was very impressed towards the woodcutter. That's why after that the angel represent him two eggs also. One is the golden and there is the silver, and the rewarded for his honesty to the woodcutter. Means, and the third again he rewarded, the third again the angel came with the woodcutter wooden axe. Okay, and after that when the angel was impressed with the man honest, after that this golden and silver, this two axe was given to the woodcutter as a reward. Okay student, I think you understand this chapter. Now go to our next page, page number 30. Is the what we learn is the moral of the story. Dear friends, we saw how the honest woodcutter was rewarded for his honesty. Means they rewarded by these two acts, golden axe and the silver axe. So truthfulness creates a trust in others. If you always say truth, then it's easily people trust you. A liar can never win the trust and confidence of the people around him or her. Those people are always telling lies. They never earn or they never win the trust and the confidence of the people. The road of truth is long and at times full of challenges, and ultimately the truthfulness always gets rewarded in the end. Means if you take a road to truth, it's a very long path, but when you reach the destination, you always win the path. So that's why, and you get rewarded at the end also. So that's why you always take the, always choose the path of truth. Never go in a liar path, because when you go one time a liar path, after that sometimes the truth or never win the trust of any people or confidence of any people. If you always walk in a truth long truth road, that time you always feel that everyone trusts you and you feel very happy that time. Okay student, now learn this chapter very carefully at your home, read it again and again. Okay, the next video I will explain you the meaning of this chapter and the question answers. Thank you.